Greetings, Kiss Nation. Dangling with tribute album, Kiss Forever Band, Live and Loud. And this came out in 2006, and this is the third and final Kiss Forever Band album. Now, the second one was an acoustic live album, which I couldn't get a hold of. I wanted to get a hold of it, but I was only lucky enough to get a hold of Carnival Souls, which I talked about in the last review, and Live and Loud. And this is an awesome live album. Whenever I talk about Kiss tribute bands and they put out live albums, they're usually pretty fucking good. I talked about Clown Alive 2, which that was an awesome album. I talked about Kissology July 51, that was an awesome album. And I talked about a band who put out a tribute album, which was also a live album, Catherine Kiss Covers. Although they're not really a tribute band, but they had a member from a Kiss tribute band, Kiss My Ass. And that album was pretty good also. But this album is an awesome live album. It's got songs from the 70s, the 90s, and the 80s, and it's pretty cool. This album also has a companion DVD, kind of like the same thing with Kiss Symphony. And what's also really cool, much like with Carnival of Songs, you get really cool pictures, like the Catman, Starchild, and you get really one cool picture like this. That's pretty fucking awesome. What's also really cool is they're wearing the Love Gun costumes, which I've always liked those costumes. And the DVD, I've tried to get a hold of the DVD before, but I never really could get a hold of the DVD. And the live versions, very live versions of the songs, what I think of them, let's give this.
Face Ace. Let's have a trip into the void. 1, 2, 3, 4. Losing power and I don't know why. Like a magnet, let me go.
Into the void.
They gotta get away, get away.
Into the void.
I'm being pulled out.
Into the void.
This place is spinning, spinning around.
Into the void.
I'm being pulled out into the black hole. We'll be right back.
unholy. I was created by man, you know I'm unholy. Yeah, 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 yeah. I am the incubus, I live in you, the rock that burrows to your grave. But you are the beast, just calls me by my name. You send your children to work, you serve bastards and whore. So now you know, you created me on the day that you were born. I'm holy, I was created by man. Yeah, I'm the Lord of the flies in the world. I'm holy. From the left and the far across the father of flies, yeah. I'm holy. I'm
right. rip it out.
Just can't find the sound. Just
just a few more hours, and I'll be right home to you. I think I hear them calling. Oh, Beth, what can I do? Beth, what can I do? You say you feel so empty, that our house just in a home.
This song's called Shout It Out Loud!
On Kiss for a Band Live and Loud. Like I said, this is an awesome live album. It's got some awesome live versions of the Kiss songs. And what I didn't mention in my Chronicle of Songs review is that how they altered the S's on their Kiss logo. I always kind of thought that was pretty interesting that it's not that altered, but just kind of made the S's more wavy. It's pretty cool. So I want to talk about their live versions of the songs. Let's get to it. Starting off with Deuce. Excuse me. Their version of Deuce is pretty cool. I always loved their intro to Deuce. Your intro to the band in general. You wanted the best. You got the best. The hottest tribute band in the world. Kiss for a Band. Always loved their intro to themselves. It was pretty cool. Now we got Strutter. I love this version of Strutter. I liked it during the guitar, in the middle of a song, I bet you say Strutter. Kind of like how they did it, how Kiss does it in the studio. But they're doing it live, so that's pretty cool. Next we got Into the Void. The first song is an Ace song. That's pretty cool. This live version of Into the Void, it's pretty cool. I like it. Next we got War Machine. This is an awesome live version of War Machine. And this is the song where Vagene breathes fire. And because during a little bit of the song you hear the fire sirens. That's pretty awesome. Alright, then we got Harder Than Hell. Like Harder Than Hell, it's really awesome. Next we got Shock Me. Another Ace song. Nice! I love this version of Shock Me. Really love the guitar solo that the Ace does. It really shows that he's really doing his own thing along with doing Ace's solo. Because you hear a little bit of Ace, but you also hear a little bit of his own spin on things. That's cool. Next, we got Help Me For Loving You. This is an awesome live version of Help Me For Loving You. And I think this is a really good version, but God Sings Paul does an awesome job singing the song. Next, we got Unholy. What I really am not a huge fan on is that they took out the bass solo that the Gene guy did. But other than that, this version is pretty cool. The Gene guy does a really good job singing the song, and we get the drum solo from the guy that goes to Peter Chris, which is pretty cool. Then you get Lick It Up. Another awesome live version of Lick It Up. You get a little bit of that huge snippet that Kiss always does, but then it's followed by the I Want You, I Need You that Kiss always does, which is pretty cool. Then we got I Love It Loud, an awesome live version of I Love It Loud. It's pretty cool. Then we get Rip It Out. This is the second time Rip It Out's made an appearance on a live tribute album. The first appearance was on Catherine Kiss Covers. It was awesome on that one, and it's awesome on this one. And it's the last Ace song on this album. And damn, this is fucking cool. Next we got Black Diamond. The guy that does Peter does a really good Peter voice. I like his voice. And it's a really awesome live version of Black Diamond. Next we got Beth. Like I said in the Purple Songs review, I like their version of Beth because they have their own orchestra tape. And they use their own orchestra tape for the live version. And it's a really cool thing. So that's pretty cool. Next we got Shout It Out Loud. I always love when this band does Shout Out Loud because they switch between the Paul guy singing a verse and the Ace guy singing a verse. I thought that was pretty cool. Next we get Rock and Roll All Night. Awesome closer to an awesome live album. So there you have it. This is an awesome live album. There's some awesome great versions, live versions of the Kiss songs. And I would give it a 10 out of 10 for the final verdict. As a live album, this is 100% live. Like, the crowd is live. The vocals are live. Like, nothing has been touched up in the studio like the last few live albums, like the Kiss tribute albums and tribute bands. And Final Act 2 was heavily touched up in the studio. Which, I'll talk about that one. That was an awesome live album. Kiss All You Like Before. Same thing. That was touched up in the studio, but it was still an awesome live album. This, we edited some stuff out, but they mostly made it 100% live album. And I think that's pretty cool. The first Kiss treatment. So yeah, 10 out of 10. Just another view of Kiss Forever Band of Live and Loud. Hope you liked it. Next time meet, I'll be going and talking about a tribute album for Eric Carr. I'm a legend tonight. Later.